my channel. So in this video, I am showing you another last minute Halloween costume. This Victoria's Secret model costume literally requires like the least amount of energy, the least amount of effort. It's just super easy and you are going to be looking super fly. I think it's a really cool costume if you do it with like a gang of your friends. So like, you know, all of you guys dressed up in like pink jammies or like pink robes with the angel wings. You guys are just gonna be murdering it this Halloween. So if you guys wanna learn how to create this hair, makeup, as well as the DIY angel wings, please keep watching. So let's start with the outfit, starting with the DIY angel wings that I created. So what I like to do is I don't like to make from scratch. I'm more of like that semi-homemade. So I found these bat wings at the 99 cent store. They obviously cost me 99 cents. So I'm just taking them because they already have the shape and I'm just cutting off this like janky fabric that they had on it. And then I'm going to take cheesecloth that I also found at the 99 cent store just so it has like a stronger base and also a white base. So I'm taking that cheesecloth and laying it over my bat wings, and then I'm going to use tacky glue just to secure it in place. Now that I have my white base secured, I can now take the tacky glue again and then lay out all my feathers. So I am just taking this bag of feathers that I found at Michael's and laying them randomly. It doesn't really matter. This is just to give it like some feathers on it in case anything does show, but we have larger, prettier feathers that we're actually gonna lay on top over this. So we are just covering our wings with all the feathers, front and back, because remember that the wings on the inside are what's gonna be showing the most. So both sides are definitely important. So once you have everything covered with those cheaper feathers, you're gonna take your good feathers. These I've actually had for years just in a storage box, like with all my crafts and stuff. So these are from Mother Goose. They're actually so amazing. I love them. They were from an old job that, I don't know, we had a lot of leftover. So I'm just using those, and these are actually in strings. I'm going to link you below which ones I think are the best for these wings that will make it super easy, because you want to glue them in rows. So just hot glue and then place over like in rows, starting from the bottom and working your way up. So once you're done hot gluing everything in place, you're going to then flip it around, and then we have to do the front side. So for this front side, I am using different feathers because I actually did not have enough of this back side. So I'm using these like ostrich type feathers that you see here and just placing them and sprawling them to go outward. So once you're finished with the inside, what I did was grab a cheap feather boa that I found at the thrift store actually, and I'm just using that to trim the top layer because you can kind of see where the string is from the feather. So I'm just gonna cover that with the boa. So taking that hot glue all the way through, placing the boa, and you can kind of see here like what I'm talking about where you can see that trim. So I just wanted to cover that. So that is it. When you guys have everything in place, you have your angel wings. Now you can pair these angel wings with a pink pajama like I did from Victoria's Secret, or even a pink silky robe. So moving on to hair and makeup. So I'm just gonna start with my hair, that way it can set while I'm doing my makeup. And I just finished blow drying it actually. I just did a simple blow dry. And I'm gonna go in now with my beach waver, which was actually the tool they used on the Victoria's Secret show last year. So it just gives you, you know, those like bombshell sexy waves. Very effortless and just voluminous. That's the look that we're gonna go for today. So I'm just parting my hair like two sections, and I am going to start at the bottom. So I'm going to take my beach waver and kind of leave a little bit of this ends out, and then I just press go and it kind of self-rotates, holding it for just a few seconds, and then I release it and you're left with this little wave. And we're gonna do that all the way through. I'm gonna switch it to right and do the same thing on this side. The front, that way it's out of my face when I'm doing my makeup. And now I'm gonna take one of my favorite products of all time, favorite hair products of all time, this Orabe Après, these Parisian names, man, Après Beach Wave and Shine Spray, and spray that all over my hair. It smells so amazing, guys. It smells so good. This product is changes your hair life. So while that sets, I am going to move on to my makeup. So I'm going to start with my Charlotte Tilbury Wonder Glow, just to prime my face and give me that Victoria's Secret glow. This thing just literally perfects all skin. Sometimes I'll even wear it just alone with no makeup because it's so beautiful on the skin. Next, I'm going in with my Bare Minerals Bare Skin Foundation. I feel like the Victoria's Secret makeup artist really allow models' faces to shine through, so I don't want anything super cakey. I just want a really natural finish. And then I'm looking a little tired, so I'm just gonna put a little bit of concealer. Next, I'm going in with Brow Wiz by Anastasia. I just want a really natural brow. I think the Victoria's Secret models have more of a full, like, feathery type of brow, so that's the look that I'm going for in this look. So those are my brows, and now I'm going to take NARS The Laguna Illuminator and mix it with Pixie. It is their sheer cheek color in Rosy. So now I'm just setting all these liquids and creams with a setting powder. I'm using Wet n Wild's Dulce de Leche. So I'm taking that lighter shade and just applying it anywhere where I crease. And then I'm gonna go in with the bronzer side and just bronze my cheeks and contour my cheeks just a little bit. Moving on to eyeshadow. So I'm starting with Buck and putting that in my crease. And then taking a smaller brush and also taking Buck and putting it on my lash line, or along my lash line. And then coming up into the outer corner. Then I'm gonna take Half Baked and place it on my lid. And then taking Naked and just kind of blending that all up from the crease. And then even coming down with Naked. Finishing off with Virgin, the lighter shade, and just highlighting my brow bone. So now that I have all like my powders and everything, I'm going to take Maybelline's Brow Drama just to get some coarseness in my brows. Not that I even need it, but I'm just going to brush them so I have this like feathery effect. It just brings all those little hairs up and sets your eyebrows so they're like nice and fuzzy. So next I'm taking my Wonder Pencil by NYX and just going in my inner rim of my eye. That way I look a little more awake. I'm just gonna do a really small gel liner across the top of my lash line just to give it some definition. And I'm going in actually not with black. I don't want, their makeup isn't super harsh and dramatic, so that's why I'm going to use Espresso. I have been highlighting my inner corner literally since I read this article about the Victoria's Secret models and how that makeup artist at the time, this was years ago, would always highlight and how it makes you look more awake and whatever, right? So ever since then, I've been highlighting my inner eye like every time I wear makeup. Really, that's like my signature makeup move. So I'm taking this Marc Jacobs, I can link you the color. You see I use this literally every single day, so it's completely rubbed off. But it is called, I think, Twinkle? I wanna say like Twinkle Pop, and it's, I'll link it down below. So I'm just putting that in my inner corner.
I feel like if I wear eyeshadow and I don't include this, my makeup is not done.
And then just gonna finish off my eyes with some mascara. This is the Manga Rock Voluminous by L'Oreal. So now I'm just going to highlight my face using a little high beam at first, and then I'm gonna set it with Champagne Pop by Becca. So for lips, I'm gonna use NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in the color Mulan. Kind of dabbing it a little bit, patting it so it looks a little more natural and flushed. And then going in with the Buxom Lip Creams in the color Rose Julep. And that is my finished makeup look. So now I'm gonna take out these little hairs. Just gonna shake it out. Literally the least amount of effort. I told you. So that is it for this Victoria's Secret model tutorial. I am so excited for the Victoria's Secret show. They just announced that it's going to be in Paris. Bella Hadid is walking. I mean, I am just waiting. I saw a little teaser on it, so I know that there's gonna be like a multicultural section. You know how they always have like their themes and concepts? So my God, these, like the amount of months and money that they spend on these wings, it's just literally an art form. So I just wait for it year after year, sipping wine, eating pizza by myself usually. And yeah, I'm just really excited for the show. I really wish I could attend one, like one day. Hopefully I can attend one. Please give it a like if you did enjoy this video. And also leave me a comment below telling me who your favorite Victoria's Secret model is. Mine is Adriana Lima for sure, the OG. I just love her so much. And I think it's cool that she still walks in the show. And please subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you in my next video. Bye. I think she still does. Fuck, does she? So in this video, whoa, my eyes just got really big there.